Park. My name is David Snow. We're having barstool conversations, keeping proper social distance, and focused on some local talent. But tonight, we're very privileged to have some international talent with us, and a very special guest. We've got the mayor of Galway City, County Galway, Ireland. Roughly what, Mike, about 3,000 miles away, would you say?
Oh, that, yeah.
So Mike Cubbard is the mayor of Galway. He's been gracious enough to join us, and we're really happy to have him. And so Mike, what we've been trying to do is have a conversation like we would normally if you were in this empty bar, but normally when it's full, we'd be sitting at the bar and having a conversation. So I'm just gonna ask you a couple questions and we'll kind of roll from there. The first question I'm gonna ask you is, if you were cast off in isolation like we are today, and you could only take one musical artist with you, who would that musical artist be? What would you be listening to specifically from that artist? And maybe if you can speak a little bit about why.
Oh, straight in there with the easy question, David. Thank you. I'd have to bring two. One, I would bring an Irish artist by the name of Christy Moore. I'm sure you've heard of Christy.
Yeah.
And a particular sound there, I suppose, which would be The Island. Christy sings The Island very well, but obviously you've got Black as the Colour, other good Irish ballads as well, Christy would sing. But then, only last night I watched online a live 1 hour 90s and noughties DJ set, dance music, so I have to bring that as well, because I'm 34, my generation would have danced for the late 90s and noughties, so to keep it upbeat and keep it, look, you're cast away, have a bit of fun as well. So I certainly bring a DJ to dance the night away into the dark night on the island.
You're going to have a lively island, it sounds like. And then when you need to bring it down, you can bring Christy in. That's great. So have you noticed, I know you're a family guy, you've got young kids, right? Am I right about that?
Yeah, three boys, they're 9, 5, and 4.
So as a family, what's been sustaining you eating-wise? Have you been eating anything different? Have you found yourselves getting into some different types of things as you try to go through your pantry and figure out what you're going to eat night to night?
No, I suppose the first week, obviously the kids are off school. Schools have been closed for a number of weeks now. So the first number of weeks, we obviously prepared our weekly shopping to prepare for cooking for the week. At the time, the takeaways were still open. You could still get a McDonald's or a Supermax over here. That's now stopped as well. So there are some days when literally you just open the fridge and whatever's there, that's what's on the menu. So we are improvising. Look, there are three small boys here as well. We're trying our best to keep healthy food on the table as well. But sure, look, it's whatever's in their fridge, whenever we get a chance to go to the local store to shop, that's what we cook. But nothing's strange.
The next question is, what have you been watching? What's been keeping you going in terms of, are you binge watching anything? And you can take this as what you're watching with the family and maybe after the kids go to sleep. Keep it clean.
I suppose in my job, certainly a lot of public events and public engagements that the mayor over here would have to attend, like any other places. And you don't get too many days or nights off. And since the last week of February, I've literally had nothing to go to, no public event whatsoever. So I'm catching up on probably shows from last year, the year before, that I would have missed out on when I became a councillor last June. So, and this last week, I've caught up on Homeland, which is a very, very good show. I like watching Homeland. And I'm catching up on Power. I like watching Power as well. Only today I was watching, it's a Netflix program called Sunderland Till I Die football program. And with the kids, then we watched Jumanji just this afternoon. So we're catching up on a lot of that. So, but again, it's a chance for me to catch up on the likes of Homeland, which I love watching. So I'm up to date now, thank God for that.
Yeah, you're running quite a range there. I just finished Sunderland Till You Die last night, so we're on the same page there. That's good.
Same page. Good watch.
So, Mike, you know, given the responsibility of your position as the mayor of Galway, as this has transpired, like what have you learned? What's been the biggest takeaway so far to date in your role?
I suppose, and no more than yourselves and literally 195 countries in the world, we're completely uncharted waters now. And nobody seems to know what's next. And even those at the very top don't know what's next. And rightly so, because there's been no precedent for this. it's all news. So as I said, like in Galway, we're not on a complete lockdown in Ireland, but it's kind of a phased phased lockdown where the government have asked the people of Ireland to stay home as best you can. Only leave your home for essential shopping, essential work, travel, and you can exercise within 2 kilometres of your home. Now in Galway in particular, we found that challenging up to last week, where the promenade in Salt Hill, I'm sure you're familiar with the promenade,
yeah,
which would be huge numbers of people walking on the prom. People kept doing that. People kept going to the local park. People kept going to the playground. And I found the biggest challenge is to try and balance stopping the big crowds gathering on the promenade and in the parks, but equally you have to allow people equally exercise and think about mental health and mental well-being to try and find the happy medium there. So what the government have now brought in is, as of last Friday, was you can only exercise within 2 kilometres of your home. That we've now engaged more Gardaí on the beat in the communities just to make sure people are adhering to that. And the Gardaí here would not be using any sort of force or any sort of intimidation to get into your home. We're not at that level whatsoever. But it's trying to put the onus on the people.
Right.
And I found them in my role. But my role, again, I would certainly take my role very seriously, that in a time where, I'm sure you've seen it yourself, there is so much information out there now. There's information coming every side, whether it be online or through WhatsApp or wherever it may be. And it's to try and decipher what's actually reality and what's true from that. What I do then, I do weekly or daily updates at 1:30 in the afternoon and 6:30 in the evening time. And I give updates on my own social media to people who follow my pages to say, well, this is what's factual today. This is where we're at. Because if you get consumed in all the information that's coming at you, it's very, very easy to get bogged down in that. So what I found in particular, in fairness to the majority of people, I would say 85%, are actually adhering to the guidelines. I myself and my wife both work in the insurance industry, our full-time role, which has been classed as an essential service. So what we've now adapted to working is 1 week on in the office and 1 week working from home. So last week I spent 9 to 5, Monday to Friday, working from the kitchen table with 3 young boys behind me. This week now Karen will do that. And that's the way we have to adapt. I suppose what I found different is people are, in the whole, nearly adapting to those changes. And even for my old job, whether it be the council role or as mayor or as the insurance broker, picking up the phone to a customer or to or an incoming call from a tenant with a query or a problem, everybody understands on the far side of the phone when they hear the kids in the background asking, Dad, can I have a juice? Dad, can I have this? People are adapting to understanding that we're actually working from home, but it's the current reality of the current norm, I suppose, that probably we're at.
Right. Is there anything you'd like, any message you'd like to leave people with in general? Not to put too much pressure on you, you covered a lot of ground there. But is there anything that you want to share?
I suppose the message is simple. It's to listen to the experts. I've said this to people in Galway here as well. Regardless of who's in government or who's the front face of who's giving the message, it's the experts in the medical sector who are behind the scenes and giving information to those. So, like, I don't particularly have to agree with the government of the day in Ireland, but I have to listen to what they're saying because they're getting information from experts in the medical sector and equally yourselves there and any other place. So what I would say is listen to what you're being told. We're not being told it just for the sake. And we're in a very, very scary space where on a daily basis we're being told how many people have lost their lives. And we've been told a lot of information about how we can carry it, who cannot carry it, and all that kind of stuff. So it's about listening. It's about just the simple measures that we've been told to wash our hands and stay safe and keep our distance and so on.
Right.
And we will get normality back. And we will come back to a place where we can meet up in the bar there and have a beer and chat like this. But for now, we have to adhere to the rules, unfortunately. But just stay safe. That's all I would say.
Well, Mike, when you come back, it's a great answer. When you come back, and when you come over here, we'll at least get you a 50% discount on your first pint.
I would hope so.
It's Now, this is the official bar of Galway United Football Club on the South Shore. And would you say that we're on the right track by adopting such a club?
Absolutely, yes. The best club in the West of Ireland by a long way. We met on the League of Ireland dash when we played a game of football in every ground in the country of Ireland, on the island of Ireland. And there's not too many other clubs that have done that, so you're certainly up the right track there.
That's right. Well, Mike, thank you so much, and we appreciate you taking time with us. I want to thank our first responders. I want to thank the medical professionals that are working so hard, the people working in supermarkets, the folks that pick up your trash, the town workers that are keeping things running. I know Mike can relate to that. We want everybody to stay safe, keep the proper social distance, and stay tuned. We'll be doing more of these. I can't promise you we'll be reaching 3,000 miles across the ocean, but Mike, so great to have you with us, and please take care of yourself and your family and all the good people back in Galway. Thank you.
Absolute pleasure. Thank you very much.
Thank
pleasure.
You.
I see the souls of so many friends. I see us all back here again.